Thank you for watching Scary Bear Attacks. If you like this episode, please remember to hit the like button and leave a comment or two, then subscribe and click on the bell to receive notifications of whenever we release new videos. Also, please remember to share them to your social media.
Welcome back to Scary Bear Attacks.
Today's episode takes us to just another one of the states in our all 50 U.S. states bear attacks tour. In the state of Maryland, you might think of turtles or crabs as the most dangerous wildlife in the state, but after today's episode, you may reconsider. In northern Maryland, Gambrill State Park is a natural respite from the modernity surrounding it. The park is set on the first range of mountains rising from the lowlands that make up the eastern part of the state. It is a hub of social events for the nearby town of Frederick and features cabin rentals and tent camping sites and is crisscrossed by nature trails. Wildlife in this area includes white-tailed deer, eagles, and turkeys. Little animals like turtles, snakes, and raccoons are common. The animal that very few people count on seeing is one of the several black bears that roam the area around the park. On September 21, 2020, 55-year-old Renee Levow was enjoying a walk in the park with her two dogs. Kylie and Bones were German shepherds and enjoyed walks with Renee nearly every day. Renee worked as a home care provider for her profession, and it afforded her a comfortable life in a setting that brought her peace and comfort. They had been coming to the park together for several years without ever encountering any bears. They didn't pack bear spray, nor did they bring a firearm on any of their walks. The area around Renee's home is surrounded by a thick expanse of forest, about 3 miles wide by about 10 miles long. It doesn't have a lot of roads through it, and there are very few people in the area other than day hikers and campers. It is kind of this little pocket of wilderness in the middle of an otherwise modern and busy area. After a few miles of walking and enjoying the trees and scenery, Renee, Kylie, and Bones were only about a half mile from Renee's home. Suddenly, Kylie's ears perked up and her head pointed at something in the bushes, only about 30 yards away. Kylie dashed off to investigate while Renee looked on curiously. She probably thought it may be a raccoon or a deer, as they are both common sights in the park, but what emerged from the bushes was much more dangerous than either of these. Right when Renee saw the bear, the only thing that ran through her head was that she was screwed. She couldn't run because the bear was so close it would run her down in no time. She knew that whatever she did in the next few moments would be pivotal to her health and possibly her survival. Now Renee was no small lady. She stood 5 feet 9 inches tall, and the bear that emerged didn't look very big. Kylie ran right up to the bear and nipped it a few times on the nose, and the bear took exception to the bites and swatted out of frustration at the dog twice with its paws. Renee thought back for a moment about how to handle a confrontation with a bear. She recalled how you should make yourself look big and yell to frighten the bear off. That is what the experts recommend after all. She raised her hands above her head and waved them around while yelling at the bear. Upon seeing her movement, the bear dropped its head and quickly dashed directly toward Renee. As the bear climbed the slight hill Renee was standing on, Kylie pursued the bear and bit it on the rear. The bear paid no mind to the bites, as it clearly had its eyes set on attacking Renee. As the bear closed to within a few yards of Renee, it stood to its hind legs and reached its paws toward her. She could see every detail. Each claw of its paws and its teeth stood out to her as she studied the bear in fractions of a second as it walked toward her. The bear was about the same height as Renee and didn't seem to be a lot bigger than she was, but any bear is several times stronger than a human being. The bear growled as it closed in on Renee. It now was so close she could have reached out and touched its nose with her hands. As Renee and the bear momentarily looked at each other, the bear made up its mind. It swatted Renee in the chest very quickly and opened up a 6-inch gash on her upper breast. As she stumbled back a few steps, the bear pushed her to the ground and bit her left leg twice just behind her knee. The bear swatted Renee back in the other direction so quickly that she didn't even see the bear's paw coming at her. Before she could react to the second swat, she felt the bear clamp its jaws onto the left side of her face. Renee heard the bones around her left eye socket cracking under the bite pressure of the bear, and she wondered what to do next. When some people face death, they say their life flashes before their eyes, but not Renee. The attack happened so quickly that she didn't have time to think, reflect, or even react. Immediately after hearing her facial bones cracking on the left side of her face, Renee felt the bear bite down on the right side of her face in about the same area. She was filled with terror as she just wanted to get away and not feel the pain of another bite from the bear. Hearing the bones of her skull crunching under the force of the bear's jaws was horrifying to her, as she had no way to defend herself from the power and speed of the bear. The only thing Renee could do was to put her hands on the bear's neck and try to keep its head from being close enough for it to bite her skull again. She knew the bear was either going to kill her, or she would think of a way to keep it from doing so. Since fighting the bear off was not realistic, Renee rolled onto her stomach and stopped moving altogether. She put her arms up around her head and did her best to lay still, hoping the bear would be distracted by Kylie and Bones, or lose interest in her and leave. Renee could feel her blood gushing down her face and into her hands. She knew she couldn't take much more punishment before she would lose consciousness and possibly die. As Renee lay on the ground, she could hear the bear sniffing her right ear. It rumbled a low growl right into her ear as it inspected her for signs of life. She remained still and refused to twitch as she knew it might rekindle the bear's attack. Suddenly, everything went silent. No dogs barking, no bear breathing or growling. Renee knew if she lifted her head to investigate, the bear might see her movement and renew its attack. She lay there as still as possible for about 10 minutes, before slowly reaching her hand along her side while searching for her phone. Renee dug around in her pocket and pulled out her cell phone. Dialing 911, she relayed the location and injuries she had suffered to the dispatcher. It was only a few more minutes before first responders arrived on the scene to help her. Fortunately for Renee, one of her neighbors was the chief of the local fire department and was very quick to arrive at her location. By the time he got there, Renee had rolled over onto her back and sat up. Although she wasn't sure how much damage the bear had done to her face, she was relieved to see someone had come to help. The fire chief asked Renee a few questions as he looked her over. An ambulance was requested to Renee's location and arrived after only a few minutes. They loaded Renee up into the back and quickly drove her to Meredith Hospital in Hagerstown, about 30 minutes away. The medical team performed various examinations to gauge just how much damage the bear had done to Renee's face and head. After the initial medical assessment, the medical team decided to transfer Renee to Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore by helicopter. This hospital features one of the best trauma units in the nation, and they sutured Renee's face and scalp together over the course of a 4-hour surgery. The suturing was extremely painful, as Renee recounted, but she endured it. The medical team administered a local anesthetic to numb her flesh as the plastic surgeon sutured her wounds, but she could still feel the stitching as they went. Renee's wounds included the 6-inch gash opened up on her chest by the bear's initial swat, deep bite wounds on her left leg, torn tissues around her left ear and scalp, as well as lacerations on her left cheek and face. The bear's jaw broke her orbital bones around her left eye during the attack as well. On the right side of her face, she had bite marks near her scalp, and the nerves near her eyebrow were severed. The pictures of Renee's attack would not be allowed according to YouTube standards, so I have posted several of them on my Patreon account, linked below. They are pretty gruesome, so if you are squeamish, don't look at them. Renee was released from Johns Hopkins Hospital almost 2 days after being admitted and was walking within a few more days. She was bruised from head to toe but was grateful to escape with the injuries she had, as the attack could have ended much worse. Renee stated that it took nearly 2 years for most of the sensation on her face and scalp to return. She says it feels strange when she touches the areas that are still numb. Renee now carries bear spray and wears bear bells whenever she takes Kylie and Bones out for walks. She makes a point to recommend to people she sees walking in the park to pack their bear spray, and even recounts her attack to them to drive the point home when needed. She also tells them to play music or be loud so that they don't surprise any bears that may be in the area. Renee indicates that she still suffers from anxiety and visits a post-traumatic stress therapist to help her overcome her fears. Even though she is still filled with fear, she still walks her dogs on the same route as where the attack occurred. A brief investigation into the circumstances surrounding Renee's attack was conducted by local officials. They could not locate the bear and concluded it had left the area after its attack on Renee. They also pointed out that in 2020, a weather anomaly had reduced local acorn availability to bears and brought bears into residential neighborhoods and towns in search of food. Officials had issued warnings to local residents about the situation prior to Renee's attack. In the 10-year span between 2009 and 2019, black bears in Maryland were reported in over 480 nuisance calls from citizens. In the same period, farmers reported $18,400 worth of damage each year due to black bears. The most incredible statistic to me is that over 60 bears each year are struck by vehicles in Maryland. There are only 2,000 bears in Maryland, which is only about 12,000 square miles. This ratio means that there is a black bear for every 6 square miles, which puts black bears only half as common as in the neighboring state of New Jersey. Maryland does have a bear hunting season in its 4 westernmost counties. In 2007, lady bear hunter Cody Jones harvested a massive black bear that weighed 615 pounds and its skull measured 21 inches, 10 sixteenths, which is huge for a black bear. After reviewing the facts surrounding this episode, I am left with a few questions for you. Do you think Renee's attack was just a matter of her being in the wrong place at the wrong time? Or am I missing something? Why didn't Kylie and Bones defend Renee? Do you think Renee lifting her arms and making noise to frighten the bear instigated the attack? Did you know that something as simple as a bad acorn season could put bear populations under such stress? I will be glad to read and reply to your thoughts, so post them in the comments section below, and let's talk about it.
Thank you for watching Scary Bear Attacks. If you've enjoyed this episode, please consider clicking on the like button and clicking on the bell icon. We'll help you know when we post our new episodes. Posting our video links to your social media profiles furthers awareness, and it's fun. We slashed our prices in our merch store, linked below, so check out the bargains there while you shop. As a member of our human community, remember to adventure bravely and be careful out there, especially in bear country.